Okay, Mom, I'll be right there.
Dennis is my claim to fame. He wasn't perfect, but I've been wondering for a long time why I couldn't catch him at something. I'm sure he got away with something. Notice I didn't catch him at it.
There was a group that he was with. We called him Denny Joe, and he had a friend, Tommy Hall, and Jerry Jones, and they were called the Three Musketeers, and quite often they were together.
The thing I think is unique about them is that there isn't anything they wouldn't try, but they know when to quit. And we're well-disciplined people, and that doesn't say they weren't having their fun.
He was not only a football player, he played basketball, run track. He was just all-around athlete.
He seemed to pick up on General Eisenhower's military life, and I always wondered if that might not have been one reason that he got interested in West Point.
This is West Point, the television show, one of Denny Joe's favorite programs, and an inspiration to join the long gray line. Cadet Lieutenant Charles E. Thompson, Company M2, assigned as your host. Happy to have you at West Point. Actually, the story you're about to see takes place at Camp Buckner, where we have summer training. It was there that Cadet Dennis Reimer was put to a decisive test. The question was courage, not physical courage. He had plenty of that. But did he have the courage to make it through 4 years at West Point?
On behalf of the United States Corps of Cadets and WKDT, we would like to thank you for a lifetime of service to our nation. Go Army!
Be Navy! Hey!
There's something happening here, but what it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there, telling me I got to beware. I think it's time we stop, children. What's that sound? Everybody look what's going down.
All gave some, and some gave all, and some stood through for the red, white, and blue. Some had to fall.
Sir, I just wanted to take this time to tell you how much we appreciate you, your service to this country. As you know, I wrote a song for a Vietnam veteran I met back in 1989. And you remind me of that song, sir. As a matter of fact, you are the very definition of that song. All gave some, but some gave all. You, sir, are some gave all. Thank you.
Some gave all.
Now, 20 years later, General Reimer takes over an army that is also restructured. Reimer said much of that credit belonged to the soldier he replaced, General Gordon Sullivan.
I realize that I have big shoes to fill. I will do my best. But I would tell you about General Sullivan is that together with Secretary Stone and Secretary West, he reshaped the army and kept it trained and ready.
What's first on your agenda?
Well, I think first and foremost, I think anybody in this seat has always had the goal of making sure the Army stays trained and ready. I say soldiers are our credentials, and I say that because it's so true, so true, so true, so true.
Oh, hi, General Reimer. Would this be all for today? 604 is your total. Will you be paying cash or check? Oh, check. Can I see some ID, please? No ID. Can I see some sort of credentials, please? Oh, those are your credentials.
Boy, he was really funny. You know that?
Good morning, General.
Good morning, Lisa. Nice to be here.
Nice to have you with us. All right, General Dennis Reimer, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Has anybody seen Denny?
Who?
Has anybody seen Denny?
Maybe he's out running.
Has anybody seen Denny?
Haven't seen him.
Maddie, could you come in here? I'm trying to find Denny Reimer.
Okay, sure.
Have you seen Denny?
No.
I can't find Denny.
He's probably out. Let's go.
Anybody seen Denny? His car's here, so I know he's around here somewhere.
Anything you can do, we appreciate it. Please help. Please, your army needs you. Please, your chief needs you. Please, sir, anything you can help out with?
Sarge, you hit me up yesterday. I have already given. That's all I'm going to give you.
Please help. Anything you can give, we appreciate it. Thank you. Bless you.
What are you asking for today? Order upgrade the chief's car. I'll give you my whole wallet.
Thank you, sir.
Chief needs a new car, bigger car.
Bless you, sir. Thank you, sir. Bless you so much.
Hey, Denny and Mary Jo, retirement is great. As you can probably tell from this tape and some of the guys you never thought were particularly funny before, there's lots of energy out here in retired life, and you're going to enjoy every moment of it. It is lots of fun, and your friends are out here waiting for you, and there's lots of laughs and life to come.
Well, I had left things in pretty good shape at Fort Carson and down at Fort McPherson, Fort Scott, and as chief of staff. Somebody's going to have to pick up the pieces now after Denny, after he's been to all those three places. Will that be all right?
That's beautiful.
As chairman of the Republican Conference and as congressman of the 4th District of Oklahoma, your home state, I congratulate you both and commend you for such fine service. I wish you well as you all start this next chapter in your life, and if there's anything I can ever do to be of service, don't hesitate to call. Go Army, beat Navy.
Let me just tell you thanks from the Non-Commissioned Officer Corps for what you've done. Thanks for your faith and support and confidence in us through some pretty tough times. It's been great serving with you. There's been a few times that I wished I would have stayed in Saudi Arabia a couple of additional weeks back in October of 97, but it's been a great tour, and thanks for the great ride you've done for the Army.
General Reimer, I'd like to take a moment on behalf of all of us in country music to thank you for your many years of service to our nation and our Army. It's like that old saying, for those who have fought for it, freedom has a different flavor. And sir, we wish you only the best and a little Oklahoma sunshine wherever you go.
Denny, Mary Jo, from all your friends and all your colleagues in the Army, Godspeed and best wishes.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away.
And I'm proud to be an American. There ain't no doubt.